I just have to get over to the ramp, put it up on the trailer, and take it home. All right, raise the keel, put the locking bolts in, lower the keel onto the bolts, take the tiller and the rudder off.
Out of the water, rinse it off, used a rag. I'll do better at home. And now it's time to derig it, drive it home. I'll take off the dock lines, take off the fenders. You do everything as much as you can on the ground before you climb up on top of the hull. It just saves a little bit of time going up and down, up and down. I got the engine off the back, put it on the front of the trailer. I'm going to leave this dock line on because I'll wrap it on the mast. So I take the anchor off, but if you tie it up in a couple of different places so it doesn't come off while you're driving, there's no reason why you couldn't just leave it on, but I don't usually take it off. Take the furling line all the way out, wrap it up, tie it up on the jib itself, and leave it there while I'm trailing. I usually leave the mast crutch, the belly strap, and this arm, we leave it all in the car. So I figured while I'm in the car, I'll take this stuff out. For the mast crutch, I drilled a hole in one of the pintles, and this way I can lock it in place on the gudgeons so it doesn't come up. I had that happen one time, dropping the mast down. I got a rope caught. I tried to pull it back up. The mast crutch dropped down to the ground. Now what do I got? I can't get the mast back up, and I can't get it down. So I was kind of stuck there for a little while. I didn't want that to ever happen again, so now I have a lock. Put the strap here, and I'll just leave it up in the cockpit just to remind me that it's there. I'll do that later. So I'm pretty much done back here. I'm going to go up, get things cleaned up. Put some of this stuff in the cabin. Put a couple of fenders under it. Before I get too much farther along, I want to take the keel off of the bolts. And that's just going to rest on the bunk on the trailer. Line in here is going to be a little slack. I get some of these lines off of here. So we can get the boom out of the way. I can leave the sail cover on. I'll just take it off of the mast so I can get to the halyard. I'm going to attach the main halyard to a cleat here. Take it out of the pulleys there. I'll leave that up forward. That'll be my mast raising line. So I bring out my mast raising line. This is a dedicated line. I run it through a special cleat here on the deck, which is just for raising the mast was this part of the single hander's package. It runs through the pulley on the bow folder. I'm going to keep this a little bit tight. Put a sheet bend on it. Wrap this over. Kind of looks like a bowline, but with two lines. I'm going to make sure I can go all the way to the pulley pretty tightly. So that'll hold the mast up. Come back over here. Give it a little tuck so it's snug. Alright, I can start to take down the boom. Get the down howl out of the way. Take the boom bang off. All of these you take off from the mast. Tie it if you want to. Just a little bit. Keep it attached up there. Alright, and then you get the any of the sail slugs out. I've got a mast gate from mastgates.com. Slugs just slide right out. Gooseneck slides right out. And I put the mast gate back in. Just like that. Ready for next time. Now I'm going to take the main sheet off. So this one comes off of the boom. And I leave it on the transom. Now this is all ready to go in. I've got the topping lift still attached. Help support that in while I put the other in where it needs to go. Then I can take it off. Got a little quick disconnect, one of these little cup kind. Snap back in place. Now I'll go up forward, take the pin out of the jib. This is the forestay. First, you have to take the little ring ding off. Then get the pin out. Put a little down pressure so the pin can come out. That's that. Now, I usually put this pin back on. Put the ring ding back in place. Now, before dropping the mast, I make sure that the companionway hatch is all the way closed so that it doesn't land on it. There's a little bit, just a little bit of clearance here. Make sure that's tight. I'm gonna reach up here, make sure I can grab it. Give it some slack. Start to pull on it. Still have it in my other hand here. Catch the jib. Step down to the cockpit seat, both sides, down to the cockpit floor, and then lay it into the mast crutch. Success! Now take the pin out of the mast. I only have one pin at the front pivot point, or I should say the aft pivot point. These connectors are undone. Put this pin up front. I'm going to need it when I attach it up there. front end of the jib furler supported. So I put this piece of wood down here. I've got these ball bungees. I use a long bungee from the pulpit and attach to the front here. It holds it down. Also keeps the jib furling line a little more secure. Keeps it from bouncing around too much. And I can reposition these ball bungees a little better. A couple more that I use. Line to keep the head of the jib, keep the head of the jib furler up there. And I'll go ahead and attach the backstay. I'll just clip it on to the single handers package cleat there. That's good. Alright, time to put the strap on. Take a quick walk around and see, make sure I didn't really forget anything. Everything's tightened up. Make sure everything's there, the hook is in, end is secure. Make sure there's no hanging lines. Make sure there's nothing I might have forgotten. Alright then, if everything looks good, I can hit the rope.
So as you can see, you can derig a Potter in 40 minutes or less. And I was just taking my time, so you can probably do it faster than that. If you like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. It would help me a lot, thanks. And why not subscribe? That helps me a lot too.
And I pull all the shrouds forward.